होने की प्रकट होने की इच्छा प्रकट की। वेदों में है तद इच्छा बहु श्याम प्रजाएति सो अकामया। भगवान ने सारी प्रजाओं को सृष्टि करने की इच्छा से पूर्व कल्प में पहले कल्प में कर्मानुसारी जी कर्म करते करते प्रलय में सुप्त हो गए। उन सुप्त जीवों को फिर से कर्म में उद्बुद्ध कहने के लिए भगवान ने इस ब्रह्मांड की सृष्टि की। भगवान के कारणाब्धिशाही महाविष्णु के निश्वास से ये ब्रह्मांड प्रकट हुआ है और इसी में भगवान की लीलाएं होती हैं। भगवान का अंतर्वास और एक बाह्य आवास, तो उनके एक ही साथ चार मुह प्रकट हो गए, इसलिए ब्रह्मा जी को चतुर्मुख कहा जाता है। इसके हम क्या करें, इतने में पानी में व्यंजन वर्ण का 16वां और 21वां में गोलोक विहारी श्रीहरि ने वेणु वादन किया। कमल से उत्पन्न हुए ब्रह्मा जी के कर्ण को और उसमें कमल लाल में ये 14 भुवन हुआ, जिसका मध्य भाग जिसमें आर्यावर्त में माना जाता है और इसी में साम मनु रह प्रकट होकर उन्होंने प्रजाओं के सृष्टि की। पत्ति का स्थान ये मथुरा धाम के रूप में ये समस्त भगवान के अवतार समुदाय विराजमान है।
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल प्लीज ट्राई नॉट टू कीप योर बैक।
अनंत पद्मनाभ की,
बोलो श्री अनंत पद्मनाभ की जय। अनंत पद्मनाभ की जय।
This is the deity of Anant Padmanabh, and as Maharaj also spoke in the morning, that from him all the cosmic manifestation takes place, all the creation takes place. He resides as Karnabhishai Vishnu in the ocean made of his own sweat, and he desires that creation should take place, because from the previous creation, in the previous universe, all the living entities who were not yet perfected and they were still going through the chain of in the law of karma, and they were doing their karma. So they went back and they were in the slept form, and then they were like in the latent position, and now he wakes them up again and injects them, and this happens through Shiva, because he is completely transcendental and this material universe is completely material, that means jad. So these two different instincts cannot intermingle with each other. So in between there is a tattva which is compatible for both transcendental and material instinct. So that is called Shiva tattva. So from that is also, we call them Shiva tattva. He is also known as Shiva tattva, Sada Shiva tattva. So from him this cosmic manifestation takes place. Also Prabhuji said that from this Padmanabh Brahma appeared. From his from his navel, this lotus appeared, and in this lotus, Brahma, when he took birth, he looked in four directions, and his four mouth appeared. That's why it's called Chaturmukh Brahma. But he could not see anything, so he started going down in the stem of the lotus. But he went there for so many long time, went for millions and millions of years, but he could not find any end to that stem. So then he came back, and then he heard. कौन सा अक्षर था सत्रवा और इक्कीस
हाँ सोलहवा और इक्कीस
सोलहवा he heard the 16th and 21st consonant or vowel that is called ta pa. So he heard that and he understood that I must perform austerities. So he started performing austerities, and he performed those austerities for again thousands of years. And then when Krishna got pleased, then Golok Bihari Krishna, through his flute, he made him hear Brahma Gayatri and Kama Gayatri. And in that Kama Gayatri also he received Ashtadash Krishna Mantra. And with those mantras he again worshipped Krishna, and then he was given the whole knowledge. Kya shlok tha apka? Sarahasyam tadangancha vihan gaditam maya.
Gyanam parama
guhyam. Gyanam parama guhyam me yad vijnana samanvitam. These are the four chatur shloki bhagavat, first verse from that. Through this verse Krishna, he mercifully endowed all the spiritual knowledge with realization to Brahma. He said, I'm giving you, take it, and I'm also giving you all the realization. Because even if we get it in the knowledge form, we cannot realize it. To realize it also, we need the mercy. So Krishna said, I'm bestowing you my causeless mercy, so now you will realize it also. So that was the mercy of Krishna. So in this stem of lotus where Brahmaji is residing, this 14 planetary systems are situated. And in the middle of that is Prithvi, this earth. And region from the Sindhu River in Pakistan till Bengal. Padma River in Bengal. This area is called Brahmavart area.
Aryavart.
And within this land, from
Allahabad Prayag.
From Allahabad to Prayag, this region is called
Brahmavart.
So Lord Prabhupada is residing here. So this is exactly the middle. From here, all the creation takes place. All the living entities, they are manifested from here. So Padmanabh, he is residing here to bestow his causeless mercy and his devotion. And he gives his darshan causelessly to us. So we are praying here to Lord Padmanabh to be merciful on us, so that we can continue serving under the guidance and shelter of all the devotees, Guru and Vaishnavas coming in the parampara of Mahaprabhu. And we can also realize the same truth which Brahma has realized by the mercy of Krishna. अनंत पद्मनाभ की जय।